nodded back the wrong way, in actual fact, by Cook. And that's passed even farther back the wrong way, and I don't know whether Hill can get up on it. No, it hasn't. It's gone over four. Throw in to Newport. Young now, just hooking it into the centre to Derek. Derek trying to nod it down to fine. Radford doesn't do so. And there's a good run there by Young. Get himself back into position. Squake going up on the outside. Hooks across. A very good centre, but Brodie, also a very experienced keeper, by the way, Brodie. McLaughlin checking that all right, but it's Nielsen. Goes around the outside. I don't think he can get his cross in. He's not particularly good on his left foot. And that will be a goal kick, in fact, for Newport. Bad clearance there out of defence, and it's an even worse mistake there by Radford. There's 5 minutes left to play in this first half. Still, yet no scores. It comes out to Nielsen. Nielsen hammers it across the goal there, but a good effort there by Weir. Right off the foot of Cook there as he came herring in on it. Aylesworth now just batting it high in the air. Cook to Fenton. Fenton, I think, just managing to keep it in play for Brentford. Hooks one hard across the goal line. A very good piece of anticipation there by Weir.
Well, undoubtedly, Brentford had the better of the first half. I thought they put in many more attacks than Newport. In fact, Newport only had one attack pretty well all in the first half. And those 2 saves that you've just seen by Weir really was the contributing factor in this half of Weir, more or less against the Brentford attack for most of the first half. We take up the story in the second half with Newport playing from left to right in the white shorts.
Score 0-0. The wind dropped just a little, so we may see Newport coming more into the picture in the second half. And there's a foul, in fact, against McLaughlin for body-checking Mansley. Gelson with the free kick for Brentford. That's a very good kick indeed, but it's been nodded out by McLaughlin. And it comes loose there to Fenton. Fenton on the edge of the box, slips there. And has got himself clear. Mansley trying a first-time shot there. And good piece of play there by Sprague. And that's a goal kick to Newport. We're there, who's carrying on more or less where he left off in the first half by very good anticipation, keeping the score sheet clean for his side this afternoon. Derek just sticking it on. Oh, and this could be the first one. And a very, very fine effort there by Brodie. Brodie playing that very sensibly because he's got a reasonably strongest wind now. The wind, in fact, has come up in the last 5 minutes, so that Newport may well be able to cash in on this a little bit in the second half, and it comes through to Young. White just hooking it in there, and Radford there volleying it way over the top from a possible scoring chance, and that's a goal kick to Brentford. Mistakes on the trot, and it could, and that's the goal. I'm afraid that's a mistake by Ferguson, although it isn't in actual fact a goal, because the linesman, who I wasn't watching in actual fact, watching the ball across, had already got his line up offside. I make it just about 5 minutes left for play, still no score, but Newport undoubtedly right on top in this second half. Throw in to, well, I think it's a free kick to Brentford. A little bit of pushing by Derek. Gelson's free kick now. Sprague just pushing it forward to Derek. Hawley just nods it down there, but Derek coming in very, very quickly. The referee was quite right, Mr. Capey. Brentford, I think, now just about content to play at the last 4 minutes of this game to go home with a point. Gilson with the kick now. Got it out by Ferguson. Higginson. Hawley just hooking it into the centre there. It could be dangerous, but it's beaten everybody, and McLaughlin onto it. Trying to find his own player, but only finds Renwick and Weir now. Out. That's a goal kick. Just about 3 minutes left for play now. Fenton's nodding it forward to Mansley, and it's Ross. Lucky there, getting past really, and that's Ferguson hooking it clear. Higginson, and it's Young now, just pushing it. She'd hope down to Hill. Fenton just sending it forward, and that's a little case of pulling there by the centre forward, Cook. Weir. Hawley sending it forward. Aylesford. It's a very sound job, young Aylesford. I think very spectacular, but this is all you really want from a competent young centre-half. Certainly. When I say young, I mean very young, 16 years of age. And it's throw in to Newport. Sprague with the throw. Hill now just turning it on. And that's the throw in. Yes, it had gone over, so Hawley just sent it down the line. It wastes a little bit of time. Ferguson whipping it down very quickly to try and get it in. I make it about 2 minutes left for play now. Plus any injury time, of course, which KP will have added on. Hooked across there very well indeed. Renwick gets his head to it, and that's Cooper going on, nods it to Renwick. Renwick tries it, and there's the goal! And when he comes out from underneath there, it's Derek, the number 10 inside left of Newport County, that has put them deservedly in the lead. 1-0 with, I make it, about 1.5 minutes left to play, plus injury time. Well, that goal very late in the second half by Derek, the inside left of Newport County, gave them what I thought was a very well-deserved victory, particularly the pressure they would have been under in the first half. Pressure being the operative word in the first half, and with me I have Len Weir, the goalkeeper. He had an awful lot to do with the stopping of that pressure getting into the back of the Newport net. Len, you were, I think, probably a little bit worried in the first half, really, with the performance of Brentford.
Yes, the start of the first half. We were under quite a bit of pressure. I think we got on top a little bit, you know, halfway through the first half, and which eased it off me anyway quite a bit. You know.
Now, in the second half, you had practically no pressure at all. What
did
you think this was?
I think probably fitness. I think we, well, as the manager would tell you, he's really put us through us this year. I've never felt fitter myself. We're a young side, and I think, fitness really told in the second half.
Well, now, fitness, you are only a part-time player, aren't
you?
And there's several other part-time players in the club.
Yes.
How does this come about?
Well, I'm a painter and decorator by trade.
Mm-hmm.
I train just as much as the rest of the players. I don't really let it interfere too much with my football, the Declan side anyway.
Well, Len, thank you very much indeed for coming along, and I hope you have another 500 games for Newport County.
I hope so too. Thank you.